They stay out late at night, binge on alcohol, and maybe try on drugs, and party all night, as well as fail in school. These are actually the nightmares of parents. And Dynamic Living, the Total You, would like to invite you, dear viewers, in the next 60 minutes, as we try to discuss with our guests here, from bad to good to worse, or maybe the other way around, the prodigal teens. I am very much honored to have with me here in the studio our friends who are willing to share their experiences to serve as an inspiration, Olive, to the viewers out there. I'd like to first welcome, of course, our resident psychologist, Dr. Olive Pelagio. Maing gabi sa imo, Olive.
Maing gabi o maing gabi sa atong mga televiewers.
Okay, and of course, we are joined tonight. We have here Johnny Lebrando. Maing gabi, Johnny.
Yes, good evening once again, especially to Doc.
And Sian Moreno. Maing gabi sa imo.
Yes, good evening, Doc, and to the viewers of Dynamic Living.
Alam mo, let's start off by saying, Olive, na not everybody would want to come out in the open and share their experiences.
Yeah, and we're so thankful and blessed that they are with us today.
Yes, of course. And heto yung tinatawag natin na the prodigal teens. Tanungin muna natin si Johnny. Johnny, how old are you right now?
I'm already 27.
27. Yes. Ikaw, Sian?
I'm 39.
Okay, so medyo okay na yung mga edad na to, ha? So halos sa, maganda yung ganyang mga edad, ano? So let me ask the two of you, did you begin or start your life as well-behaved, napaka-obedient, napaka-masunurin, and you have always been following dad and mom's admonitions, and then out of the blue, bang, iba na ang takbo ng buhay ninyo? Or talagang to start with, even as kids, you know, growing up, you were already medyo mischievous talaga. Let's start with you, Johnny.
To start with, since sa akong childhood, murag 50-50 siya. Okay, since I was born in an Adventist home, so ang akong life before, you know, as a child, is that kanang ga-binagdoy, kanang bugoy-bugoy bitaw na style. Laag diri, laag dito. And then, on the other hand, sa akong, part sa akong life is that since we are church goers, so during that church time, so behavior, but then, nagyo times since kani mga bata lagi, na magdadula sa gawas, and then kitag-away sa hinana. So, that was my, childhood
so kung
years,
kung
no?
Kung baga, as a child growing up in a home where religion is a basic thing to understand, you were good and then there were times when you were bad, yeah. Parang ganon, no? What about you, Sian?
Well, Doc, as far as I can remember, when I was young, very young, malikot na ako noon, you know? But ang surroundings namin dun kasi when my dad and my mom, when they got married, dun, kumbaga, buntis si mami noon nung nagpakasal sila. So they had to start from something. So nag-start sila noon sa apartment na kami nakatira. In that time ang
you're the eldest, right?
Opo, eldest. And ang environment namin that time talagang medyo magulo pa. So I was exposed already to mga away. So bata pa lang ganun na kagad yung surroundings ko.
So medyo basag ulero ka din.
Parang ganun.
Olive, eto, mga bata, nung, kung ano yung pinaka-kinagisnan nila, parang yun yung naging ano nila.
Yeah, kasi given the, kumbaga, developmental stages, especially sa ing anak ng mga pangidaron, well, we know by Cherry of Bandora na imitation, no? Learning through imitation. So if they learned to fight back, and definitely because yun din yung nakikita nila. Pero as time goes on, especially if they already have the realization of what is good and what is bad.
Pero what age were you, yeah? But what age were you, Johnny and Shana? Parang nakita ninyo na intentionally talaga, parang you want to go against your parents' wishes. Meron kasing ganun na stage sa life eh, na parang
nagre-rebel ka.
Oh, nagre-rebel di ka. What age were you at the time?
As far as I can remember, nag-start second year high school, yeah, when I was second year high school.
And then it progressed up to what age ikaw?
College.
Until college?
When I was about to graduate.
Also? Yeah. So kumbaga, from second year high school up to fourth year college, yun yung parang rebellious moments mo. Sa'yo naman, Sian?
Kasi ako, I have two rebellious moments. Yung first ko dyan is, nagre-rebel ako pero takot. Meron naman nagre-rebel pero Go lang ng go.
So, ang so yung takot ka na stage, anong
takot, ilan lang ka? High school. Uh-huh. Yan yung tatakas ka sa bahay mm-hmm. para uminom. Uh-huh. And yung rebellious na wala na akong pakialam, that was already like college days.
Uh-huh. So, how would you relate that, Olive, to their, ano, kumbaga, heto, sabi nga ni Sian, medyo takot pa siya. Tapos later on...
Kasi yung, ano, yung high school is a little bit dependent ka pa talaga sa parents mo. And alam mo, you're still living there and ayun, andun yung mga rules, no? So, medyo takot ka talaga nun. Pero pag college kasi you're living on your own. Hindi pa din, oo. Pero, more or less, medyo marami ka ng alam eh, uh-huh. na pwede mong gawin. Tsaka, you know, a lot of people whom you can go through, if in case, no? Palalayasin ka, whatsoever, oh, hindi, wala na yung takot.
At saka siguro at that age, wala na kasing palo, yan eh.
Oo, wala na.
Diba? Wala na yung talagang pinapalo ka dahil may kasalanan ka ginawa. Uh-huh. Unlike nung maliliit pa na natatakot ka talaga kasi isang hampak lang yan eh. Uh-huh. Diba? Lalo na there are parents who really go for corporal punishment, ano? So, yun yung takot ninyo. O kaya naman, disown kayo, di ba? So, yun yung fears ninyo. Ano yung mga ginagawa ninyo na sa tingin ninyo, ayaw ng mga magulang ninyo? What were these acts na you thought na heto ay cool naman gawin and yet alam ko na ayaw ni mama o ayaw ni papa? Sa'yo?
Sa akong part is that since katong na-start ko when I was second year high school, I started kanang gambling, mm-hmm. no? And sa una, uso kay ng billiard. So, sa among school na, sa school na mo, is that, mutakas mi, mangambak mi sa pader, para lang mo, kuan, magdulag billiard, and then computer games. Mm-hmm. Uso pa na before ang Counter-Strike. So, grabe na kabil noon. So, uh-huh. Nana, almost, maurot among time dito sa computer games, and then billiard. So, pag-uli, ang akong parents, nag-ano good sila, na-expect nga, I was in the school.
And yet, you were not in school. Uh-huh.
What was the feeling?
What was the feeling na you were, you know, doing that? And expectations ng parents mo, ganito, and yet you weren't there? Walang feel lang talaga?
I feel like, in the first place, na-please na ako ang self. Uh-huh. But then, na-it part sa akong kuan, sa akong kaguling nga, I feel like kanang more guilty po siya uh-huh. na since that money akong gina-involve sa kuan sa gambling and computer games is coming from my parents.
Aha. Uh-huh. Pero nangingibabaw yung feeling na you're doing pleasurable things to enjoy, di ba? Oh, mamaya na ikaw ang interact ng Oliva. Ikaw, Sian, ano kaya yung mga ginawa mo na sa tingin mo na dapat kasi sinabi ni daddy o ni mommy na hindi to dapat gawin and yet you weren't listening to them. What were these acts?
Siguro yung ano, yung pag-inom sa gabi, mm-hmm. like for them, it's normal naman na mag-socialize ang teenager, but to abuse it, that's a different story. At that time kasi, almost like every day, gusto ko lumabas. Mm-hmm. And there was a point na I was also addicted to alcohol. Mm-hmm. And para sa akin, para bang...
At what age was this? Mga 15, 18, 20?
No, mga ano na, 18.
18, okay.
And that time... Para sa akin, matulog ako sa mga bahay ng kaibigan ko. That's very normal. Mm-hmm. Pero for them, para bang kasi papa, mami, conservative pa yung panahon niya. Iba na yung panahon ngayon. Mm-hmm. Parang gina-justify ko that time. Mm-hmm.
So, how did you feel na you were able to get out, like alcohol binging and everything? So, how did you feel about it knowing na your parents were telling you na hindi dapat? O kaya naman na matulog ka sa ibang bahay na alam mo naman na yung parents mo are very conservative. How did you feel about it? You were proud that you were able to stand on your own? Na nagawa mo siya kahit na ano, patalikod o paharapan?
I found it more of astig. Parang mami, parang astig. Uh-huh. Parang if you can't do that as a son, para kang nerd type na estudyante or what. Mm-hmm. Pero if you're like, if you can do that, ibig sabihin you're part of the society. Uh-huh. You belong.
Ah, uh-huh. So belongingness. Yeah, pero unahin muna natin yung kay Johnny, Olive, na yung sinabi niya na may feeling siya na happy siya, but on one hand, medyo guilty din siya.
Narurule niya yung ano, yung hedonistic principle ni... You know, alala mo si Freud, sabi
si Freud,
niya, it's more on pleasure principle. Uh-huh. Pero andun pa din yung part na nagigilty siya. So, good thing, because there was a realization pa din. Even though alam niya na he's doing it on pleasure, pero there's still something within him telling him na mali pa din yun. So, mm-hmm. at least, given that one, alam niya kung ano dapat yung gawin niya.
So siguro
in control pa din siya.
So in other words, that's the reason why he was able to get back on track siguro. No? Because of that parang may feeling siya of ano eh, na guilty ako na mali ito. Mm-hmm. Kasi yun yung problema natin sa mga kabataan na naliligaw ng landas na hindi na nila alam na naliligaw na sila. Uh-oh. What about yung kay Sean naman? Yung parang ang feeling niya ay astig siya.
Yun, sabi ni Maslow eh, di ba? The need to belong. Uh-huh. Kasi yun yung, ano, kumbaga, that's the society as nowadays. Parang yun nga, tinatawag kang nerd, tapos yung iba nga, binubully pa if you don't go with them. Mm-hmm. Kasi yun yung, ano eh, yun yung trend. Yun yung ginagawa ngayon. So, yun, they should be part of it. Mm-hmm. Or else, mabubully ka.
Uh-huh. So, what was the worst thing that you ever did na kumbaga, as an act of defiance to your parents' wishes? Ikaw kaya, Johnny? Was there something else aside from playing computer games and then, you know, doing billiard? Was there something else na you did na sa tingin mo, heto yung pinaka-height ng aking rebellion?
Siguro yung I was involved in, ano po, kanang drinking alcohol. Since sa among kuan, sa family, and in a Christian home, dili ko na dapat, no, mag-take og alcohol. And then, I was, you know, involved into alcoholism. And then, try po rupuan, kanang pinatawag na to prohibited drugs. Mm-hmm. And I think...
How old were you then, when you did that?
Actually, I started drinking alcohol when I was elementary. Mm-hmm. Yeah, testing pa lang. And then...
Elementary, very early.
Okay, sa among background, sa among family, ay sa among community, since more normal lang siya, kay also pa that time ang disco ana humanog after basketball league, and then na isa ka night nga mag disco, and then everybody it seems like kana ang tanan involved, no, murag walay exemption pati mga parents, mga bata, mga lolo na adto. Mm-hmm. So murag normal lang siya. Mm-hmm.
and then yung drugs, when did you try that? High school, college?
High school, and it went into college.
So, yes, medyo matagal-tagal. What about you, Sean? Did you also go into that? Or alcoholism lang sa'yo?
No, actually, mas majority sa akin yung drugs.
Uh-huh.
I started taking drugs when I was mga 19.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been into rehab like 4 times already.
In and out?
In and out of rehab. Ang pinaka-worst na nangyari sa akin, lumayas ako noon and binenta ko yung kotse.
Mm-hmm.
Binenta ko yung kotse and I went home sa bahay after a year.
Kasi nakabenta ka ng kotse.
Talagang prodigal.
Prodigal talaga siya. Dahil kinuha niya pa eh. How do we, ano, yung mga ganyan, Olive? Like for example, di ba, nakita mo, they're not just into, parang, is there such a thing as a stages in one's rebellion? O, kasi nag-start sila with computer games, inom-inom, tulog sa bahay ng mga kaibigan, mm-hmm. and then eventually they progressed to drugs, mm-hmm. they progressed into something else. So, is there such a thing as a progression or talagang pwedeng mangyari yan na in one sitting, in one event, bang, ganun ang gagawin ng kabataan?
Pwede both.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, pwede both. There are a lot of factors eh. I don't know, di kasi natin na tingnan kung ano talaga yung home environment.
Which we will discuss later.
During the, ano, and then yun ding ka-socialize nila.
Mga kaibigan?
Oo, yung mga kaibigan. How do they interact in such a way na parang may pressure on them, mm-hmm. to be with them?
Mm-hmm.
Oo, tapos yung kay Johan naman, yung parang, although, yun, yung drink, tawag nito, the alcohol, and aside from that, yun, nagpo-progress into
drugs.
And then, Sean had been into rehabilitation. So, mm-hmm. kung titingnan mo, asan yung learning, ano, yung kumbaga lessons to learn, pero medyo matagal.
Matagal,
oo,
ano?
Oo. Kasi he still goes back to the rehab,
uh-huh.
even though ando na siya.
Ikaw, Johnny, hindi ka na rehab. Nalaman ba ng mga magulang mo what you were doing eventually? Yeah. Or talagang tinago ng tinago, na walang nakakalam?
Actually, kabaligid sila.
Mm-hmm. And of course. They eventually learned about it. Mm-hmm. And So when they learned about it, how did you feel about it? Una muna eh, how did you feel about your rebellion? Kasi we call that rebellion already na alam mo na heto yung tinuturo ng mga magulang mo and yet you went into that. How did you feel about it later on? Kasi nung una sa billiard, eh, may feeling of guilt, eh, pleasure nangingibabaw, and yet there's this guilt feeling. Pero nung when you progressed into alcoholism, you went into drugs even, eh, ganun din ba na-feel mo na more of pleasure pa rin rather than yung parang nagging thing at the back of your mind na what you're doing is not really that good?
That time, ang marang nag-dominate yun sa akong kuan, sa akong self is that ang pleasure yun siya. Mm-hmm. No, and gamay lang yung part ang marang guilt na siya at that time. Kay since when I was in kanang sa akong friends, so mag-inom, so we're happy together. And marang, I feel that I am belong to them since just like kang ano brother Jan.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and ako lang balikan ka my background sa family. My family, my parents were separated.
Uh-huh.
At the age of when I was fourth year high school. So but then way back then, since when I was a kid. Murag broken family, dysfunctional ng among family. Kay when I say dysfunctional is that kung father siguro once a month lang moabot sa balay. So murag wala gyud father figure. So mauto siya ang hitabo sa.
So that's the background of his life story. How
yeah, and then another thing is dili nato malimtan sa stage sa emerging adults na agi ng testing of endurance,
mm-hmm.
testing of limits kung ahagin nako kaya ataman akong pwedeng mabuhat,
which is sometimes actually una you start with one glass and then eventually you went into 5-10 bottles kasi kaya ko pala ito parang ganoon di ba
until such time na ma-realize ni mga ops
this is it.
Ko ano man dai ni murag sobra na man dai muraging ana.
But then not everybody will have the feeling
they realization.
So yung sayo Shan in the background of your parents are also busy di ba? Kasi they were already into politics, they were already into business and everything. Well, would you say na that affected why you also went into where you went into?
Okay. Actually the time ginamit ko siyang reason. Kumbaga ginastify ko yung pagdadrugs ko.
Okay.
Kumbaga parang this is justified kasi si Papa ganyan, si Mami ganyan. Uh-huh. Pero I was like pointing fingers to other people but three fingers were pointing back at me.
Uh-huh.
And kasalanan ko naman pala all the while, no? Kasi they have their own life eh.
Uh-huh.
Mine is different. Ngayon ko lang na-realize no, nung tumanda-tanda na.
Yeah. Pero ang ikinaganda sa inyo, like ikaw and Johnny, eh, you did not wait nga umabot kayo ng 50 anyos, di ba, na wala na kayong ginawang mabuti sa buhay ninyo, di ba? So there was this realization, yes. And then, what happened when you had that realization? Well, pero you were into rehab 4 times, eh, in and out. Eh. So what happened in between those rehab moments?
Kasi, Doc, that time kasi, ang tendency ko mag-self-pity. Like, total, addict naman ako, wala naman ako, ganyan. And then I always go back to the old ways.
Mm-hmm.
And then someone told me, you know what, Sean? Maybe you're addicted to failure. And then noon, bigla naisip ko, oh, nga, no? Bakit kaya gusto ko palaging nasa baba, mm-hmm. kung pwede naman nasa taas?
Mm-hmm. Napakaganda nung kanyang no? Well, how do you, with that?
Kasi naman, di ba yung addiction, you're addicted to the experience and the feeling, not really to what you're taking in.
Mm-hmm.
Yung starting lang yun eh, yung mga ginagamit mo na droga and everything. But at the end of the day, it's the feeling kasi there are things that you don't want to experience. Mm. Ayaw mong i-face yung
so
reality.
So you hide
from the reality.
All of this. Uh-oh. And yung mga kabataan, usually they want to hide eh.
Instead of facing
Instead
their
of
problem,
facing,
tinatalikuran nila by
which
doing
is the
that.
Same with Johnny eh. Na parang he was now hiding behind that. Yung kanyang frustration siguro sa bahay, mm-hmm. yung feeling na dysfunctional yung family mo, mm-hmm. na it's not really a very happy home na you were going into.
Although
no?
Doc, diba sa kanya, sabi niya, gina-justify lang niya eh. So, andun yung alam niya talaga na talagang mali on the first place yung ginagawa niya.
Mm-hmm.
But he's still doing it kasi nga, there are things na talagang he's already into it.
Mm-hmm.
Like yung, yun nga, yung addiction of the feeling and everything.
Mm-hmm.
Yung sa kanya naman, although siguro it's more on hindi niya na-process yung kanyang feelings the time, mm-hmm. The feeling of having a dysfunctional family. Mm-hmm. I think isa din siguro if there was somebody who were able to be there to guide them, mm-hmm. and see through.
Uh-huh. So do you think na yung sa'yo, Johnny, eh, were you the type na yung pattern mo, eh, good ikaw ngayon, bukas bad ka na naman, and then magiging good ka na naman. In other words, for a few days, very sane, walang alcoholism, walang drugs. The following moments na naman, babalik ka na naman, and then mawawala ka na naman. Where was that your pattern, or all throughout you were doing it?
I think it's all throughout, and later part na rin siyang, ano,
yung... Na medyo naging good,
yeah.
Na bumalik ka. Uh-huh. Sa'yo, Sean, eh, on-off ka, no? Kasi bumabalik ka sa rehab, eh.
Ang majority talaga, Doc, bad eh. Kasi uh-huh. ang drugs kasi, inanumb yung feelings mo eh.
Yes.
So, talagang, for example, let's say birthday ni mommy, and then a friend would invite for, let's say, take drugs or what. I'd rather choose taking drugs than to celebrate.
Yeah, ganun siguro yata ang feeling nila, Oliver.
Ang hirap nga yun i-process eh. Walang psychotherapy na mangyayari kapag... ano ka pa, intoxicated ka pa.
Uh-huh. Mahirap talaga yun.
Matagal bago pwede mong i-process yung isang tao into counseling or psychotherapy kapag andun pa yung alcohol in the body
how
or drugs.
How did your parents relate to you? Like for example, na syempre kaming mga magulang, we have this, you know, feeling na pag nakita namin yung barkada ninyo na yan, alam namin kung good influence sila or hindi, di ba? Meron tayong feeling of being comfortable, so to speak. Eh. So you were hanging out, of course, with your friends kasi you wanted to have sense of belonging. And I think they were a factor for an influence to you. Eh. So how did you relate to your parents when your parents would tell you na, oy, Sean, ayoko yung mga barkada mo ha? Or did your parents, you know, never even called your attention to it? O kaya ikaw, Johnny? O hindi mo dinadala at pinapakilala yung mga kaibigan mo? Tinago mo talaga?
Talagang, ano daw, walang nangyari na dinala ko yung mga kaibigan ko sa house and then kung... Walang nangyari na naalam yung parents kung anong ginagawa namin in reality. Kasi since nag-separate na akong parents, so and then my mother went into States. So wala nang
guidance.
Wala
nang guidance. So yun yung kanya. Eh. Yung sa'yo, Sean?
Well, ano yan, there's a saying na misery loves company. So syempre miserable yung mga friends ko that time. Hindi ko talaga sila madala sa bahay.
Uh-huh.
But umabot din sa point na magpapaalam ako sa parents ko, like I'll go to a party. Pero there's no party.
Mm-hmm.
Magbibihis talaga ako, magpapabango, pero wala akong napupuntahan.
O kaya naman sasabihin mo na pupunta ka ng school. Did it happen na you made school as an excuse?
Oo, palagi. School.
Ikaw din, Johnny, ganun ba? Parang ang reason sa bahay, o kaya para humingi ng pera, eh, dahil sa papasok sa school, o kaya
may
bibigyan for school, may project, and yet you're doing, wasting the money for something else.
During Sunday,
uh-huh.
Yeah, so ang parents ko hindi na-expect na, ay, akong ipanangit sila is that naalamihin mo nga project or homework movie together with my schoolmates. And then, yet, here I am there nga, nasa computer games, mm-hmm. and,
billiard, yeah, billiards. And then inom. So you were there. Now, how did you react to, like for example, syempre society has its own norms eh. Diba? So, dinidictate ng society natin na, oh, si Sean, si Johnny, dapat na sa school, nakatapos na kayo at this age. Dapat kayo ay nag-aaral, hindi kayo gumagawa nito. Now, how do you react when, like, you hear comments? Like, for example, mga kakilala ninyo na parang naririnig ninyo na, ay, sinasayang ng mga batang ito ang kanilang buhay. How do you react to that?
For me, I feel like kanang more kong reluctant, more kong, I think I'm wise enough, no, to handle myself. Kay... Sa akong nakuhaan, observe po sa among environment is that makaingon ko nga, akato siya, naka-okay man ilang life. Well, in fact, nga, wala man siya naka-humanog kuhaan, skwela. So, okay lang siguro nga, high school lang ko taman, na di na ko makapresid of college. And then, ako pong tanaw akong kuhaan, akong parents, akong mother, undergrad, and ako lang father naka-graduate sa college. So, moto yung mga reason na ako.
Okay lang
siya.
Uh-huh. And you never felt na, bakit ninyo pakikialaman ang buhay ko? Kasi di ba, meron mga tao talaga na makikialam na, uy, Jan, ano ba yung ginagawa mo? So, how did you feel about that? Or okay lang, wala kang pakialam o wala kang narinig sa tenga mo?
Sometimes, I'm being annoyed. Uh-huh. Na pabalik-balik na lang ilang mga kuan, ilang mga advices. In fact, nga, I think that time nga kung kuan is,
kaya
I am
na
wise enough.
Yeah. Oh, you were wise already. What about you, Sean?
Well, sa akin kasi, ang addiction for me, ano yan eh, kayabangan. Mm-hmm. There was always a time na you would think you're manageable to things. And ganun ako eh. Ang daming nangyari kasi sa akin eh, from bumagsak yung buhay ko, ginawa ko reason para mag-drugs. Umangat din ang buhay ko, ginawa ko reason para mag-drugs.
So wala ka, kumbaga, both ways.
Both ways eh.
Uh-huh.
So ano pa bang kulang? Eh, lahat na naramdaman ko. So uh-huh. ginagawa ko talaga siyang reason.
Yes,
the bottom line...
Yeah, the bottom line.
Bottom line, matigas talaga ulo ko.
Kasi astig nga eh, di ba?
Astig nga eh. Uh-huh. Yun yung yes. cool. Oh, uh-huh. Cool lang, di ba?
Cool talaga.
Oh, sa kay ano, yung
sa Johnny.
Oh, kay Johnny na parang
naanoy daw siya.
Di ba kay Kasagara Manggod, kabalo naman ko sa kung gabuhaton, ganun isurihan pa man ko ni Mio, maraging nga na ba? The nag-tendency pag yun, Anna, is, kumbaga, instead nga, mugawas na ka, tungod kay ginalabel na ka-asaj, di, sige, go. Yung uh-huh. ano lang gihapon ko.
So the labeling there also has a factor uh-oh. To consider why they would
kasi
stay.
Kasi iba yung pag-approach mo na you really care na tutulungan mo siya to para makaahon. Mm-hmm. Kaysa, kaysa ka ng imuhanga, unsa na siya? Unsa naman taon ka?
I-criticize.
Di ba? Uh-huh. Oo. So parang ganun. Kasi,
pero yung kay ano naman, yung kay Sean naman, different naman yung kanya kasi parang ginawa niya talagang reason. Up or down, it's a reason.
Para
eh.
sa akin kasi hindi pa talaga, andun pa talaga yung addiction.
Uh-huh. So mahilap i-process.
Hindi pa siya nakalabas from the cycle. Mm-hmm. Kasi if tapos na yon, then andun din dapat yung realization. Pero pabalik-balik eh. So siguro nagre-relapse siya, andun yon. So later on, parang matagal bago siya nakalabas.
Because you remember, it's a cycle.
Oo, it's uh-huh. a cycle. May process siya.
May process siya.
Andun din yung sa first time, syempre, andun yung mga denial and everything. Until such time siguro na may mga occurrences or something, may mga situation na triggers back, so nagre-relapse na naman siya ulit, kaya bumabalik na naman
siya. Which is actually the most common thing that we see among addictions, yeah. Di ba? Addicts, no? When they get addicted into something, whether it's alcoholism, whether it's...
substance abuse.
Yeah, it's an abuse. Kumbaga, it's a cycle that they have to process it.
Matagal, oo. Uh-huh. Yung sakay, ano naman, I don't think he really goes into addiction na talagang... ganun ka severe. Mm-hmm. Kasi he was able to control pa man. Mm-hmm. Andun na, di ba, naa-annoy pa siya kapag kinakantsawan kasi alam niya. Mm-hmm. Oh, andun pa
kasi
yung,
kung hindi na siya naa-annoyed pagka kinakantsawan siya.
Ay, wala na yun. Uh-huh. Tulad niya, nagsiself-pity na.
Uh-huh.
Oh, so, iba yung ano nila.
So, which would be better for a teener who's going through the same things that these our guests have went into being annoyed when they are confronted with the issues or kumbaga, magsiself-pity siya?
Wala
ka mapupuntahan.
Wala. Kasi yung pagsi-self-pity, part na yun sa kanyang ano eh, sa cycle ng addiction. Sa kanya naman, kasi nga hindi siya umabot talaga sa ganun na stage. So, kaya anon yung
magkakainis. We'll take a very short break and when we return, we'll continue on discussing what changed you. Paano nangyari na heto, andito na kayo ngayon, eh bakit nag-change yung inyong perspective? We'd like to focus on that. Please stay tuned.
We are people, and we love to get connected. We connect as families because of birth. We connect as friends because we click. And we connect as communities because we care. Seventh-day Adventists are people who connect in communities called congregations, which in turn connect to form conferences, who connect together to form unions, divisions, and the General Conference. Why do we connect? It starts with a connection to the Creator, who invites us on a spiritual journey. When we journey together, we can help each other along the way. This journey is a journey of a lifetime. And as we learn and grow, life becomes filled with meaning and purpose. Our greatest joy is in helping others along the way. Wherever you are on your journey, we believe that we have something to offer that can make your life more whole. So the next time you see a Seventh-day Adventist, remember, you're not looking at someone who stands alone. They are connected to a world church that has 18 million members gathered in 13 divisions, comprised of 122 unions, formed by 600 conferences, serving in 140,000 congregations in 208 countries, who worship in 924 languages, and they all want to connect with you.
Welcome back to Dynamic Living, The Total You, with our episode From Bad to Worse to Good, Prodigal Teens, no? So kanina diniscuss natin yung ano yung journey ninyo doon eh. Bago ko kayo tanungin doon na what was there something that made you start thinking about your future? Let me ask Olive. Olive, ano yung mga common behavioral patterns or problems na nangyayari sa mga teenagers talaga, which is even today we are faced with them 100 times.
Yun, yung mga pangyayaring ganito.
Mm-hmm.
Habitual drinking, alcoholism. Buti nga, ganun lang yung sa kanila eh. There are those talaga na kamay, no? They nag-aaway,
nakikipagsuntukan.
Nakikipagsuntukan.
Mainit ang ulo.
Oo, mainit yung ulo. Lahat yung mga ganyan. And that's part actually of ano?
Itong ginawa nila sa kanilang buhay when they were younger, was it part of the growing up process?
Oo, ano?
Kaya ko tinatanong sa'yo yan, if it's part of the growing up process, kasi yung mga magulang, syempre, when they see their children acting like that, doing these things, you know, parang ang feeling ng mga magulang, it's the end of the world.
When in fact, alam mo kasi, sabi nga nila kanina, I don't know, I forgot who among them said it na parang, they have their own life. Their parents have their own life too, and they too. Whatever happened to them, the learning experience is there. At least they learn from something. Kasi at the end of the day, reality is, gagawa din talaga sila ng sariling buhay nila. And then out from that, they will come to the feeling of, okay, this is what I have done, this is what I have achieved, and I think tama na to, and I have to do something more than that.
Mm-hmm. So yun na yung gusto kong sundan ngayon. Was there something in at the back of your mind na heto, iniisip ninyo, ano kaya ang kinabukasan ko? What future do I have? Did you have that feeling, Jenny, when you were doing all these things?
Yes, definitely.
Uh-huh.
When I was in my status in college, second year college, mm-hmm, at that time, and then
parang nagising ka lang isang umaga, paggising mo ganun, oops, teka, ano ba ginagawa ko sa buhay ko? Was it like that?
Yeah. One time, na ako sa dormitory, so I was alone in my bed, and at that night, galing ko sa kuan, sa kaamulan.
Mm-hmm.
So, 1 week wala sa school. So,
absent.
Yeah, absent. And then, I came back to, sa among campus. And then, kinabukasan, yun nga, I realized my roommates were busy having their homeworks, their assignments, their projects. And there, I am sleeping, and then, walang ginagawa. Na-feel ko noon na, kabi, ano sa kaya akong kuan, ano sa akong life, ano sa akong future ka, kung still, I will continue this kind of kuan, this kind of life.
So may mga failing grades ka?
Meron uh-huh talaga. And then, binalikan ko talaga.
Uh-huh. What about you, Sean? Did you also have failing grades at the time? Or talagang, meron kasi iba na may magagaling pa rin eh,
uh-huh,
kahit papaano.
Kahit mag-absent ka, pagbalik mo, kuhapan mo pa din.
Uh-huh.
Yung iba na, ginagawa nila yung ano eh.
As an excuse,
kasi kaya ko naman
kaya
eh.
Ko naman. Oh. Did you also have that, Sean?
Most of my grades talaga fail. Fail talaga sila.
Uh-huh.
And especially yung attendance, yun ang pinaka-ano ko talaga. Irresponsible ka na when you're into drugs talaga.
Mm-hmm. And what was that something na bakit parang sa kanya, si Johnny, na-realize niya na, oops, ano kayang ginagawa ko dito ngayon? Did you also have that in your at the back of your mind na, you know, parang nag-isip ka na, ano kayang gagawin ko sa buhay ko talaga?
Well, actually, Doc, yung turnaround ko nangyari in sa rehab, yung fourth rehab ko in Pampanga, the counselor asked me a question. Sabi niya sa akin, Sean, do you know what's the meaning of love? Sabi ko, yes. Oh, I have a question to you. Sabi ko, what's your question? Sabi niya, give me 5 people that you love. So sabi ko, si Papa, si Mommy, si Amy, my sister, my brother, and my son. Sa lublog ko, ang dali naman tong question na to. Bila sabi niya sa akin, you forgot somebody. Sabi ko, sino kalimutan? You said five lang. Mm-hmm. You forgot yourself.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Nung sinabi niya, dun talaga ako tinamaan. Mm-hmm. And I realized na, I thought I loved my family, my parents, pero how can you love people if you don't love yourself?
Yes, kasi yun yung bottom line, yes, Olive.
Yeah, you cannot give something which you do not have. Mm-hmm.
So, yun yung turning point niya, oh, na na-realize niya na yung mga ginagawa niya is self-destructive. Mm. In other words, if you do these things, that means you don't love yourself. Kasi hindi naman yung family mo ang outright na masasagasaan ikaw eh. Di ba? Did you also have that feeling na, I need to love myself in order for me to move forward? Or sa'yo, eh, yung turning point mo lang eh, ano ko yung ginagawa ko? Lahat sila busy. Tapos ako walang ginagawa.
Actually, ang turning point sa akong life is that when I was is about to graduate sa college, so fortunately, no, nakita na ko akong isa ka-roommate, no, reading his Bible. And since then, murag, since ang personality na ko is that kung unsa ako makita, awato na siya, kanang, murag mimic style ba. So, moto siya nga time, and nakatag siya impact sa tuwa, ay sa kuwa. Ano ang wala lang kasi na notice, but then I starting, no, reading my Bible once a day. So, and then it went into kanang after sa graduation ako, when there was a one time nga kanang program sa TV kanang 3ABN, the Angels Broadcasting Network, and then there was a pastor sermonizing about the love of God. Simple lang talaga yung ano message niya. He was talking about Jesus dying for us all. And then, that time, I recalled all those miserable things, all those miserable times sa akong life. Mm-hmm. Nga, I was wasting my time, my effort, mm-hmm. the money of my parents, my schooling. So, that time, my tears went slowly down mm-hmm. sa akong eyes. And then, ako lang mag-isa. Yeah. Ako mm-hmm. lang mag-isa. Ako na-feel lang, was kanang, marakog ganang, ano ba nga, Johnny, grabe ka talaga. Ang love sa Ginoo sa imo ay mo lang gisayang-sayangan. Mm-hmm. Ang parents, ang efforts ng parents, imo gisayang-sayangan. So that time, more...
It was your turning point. Oh, pero let me go backtrack a little bit. Was there a time na you really had a head-on collision with your family also? Ikaw, Sean, did you parang, oh, ito talaga pinakagrabing away namin ng mga magulang ko o kaya ng kapatid ko?
Yes, almost to a point na magsasakita na.
Uh-huh.
So, umabot na rin yung talaga nakaporma na kayo.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't care kung sino man yung
kaharap. You were beyond caring at the time. Eh. Uh-huh. And looking back at the time, ngayon na okay ka na, you're on track already. Would you say na you were embarrassed with what you did?
Yes, oo naman. Uh-huh. Minsan na ano ako eh, parang nakukonsensya pa rin. But again, things like that can be either liability or asset.
Mm-hmm.
So, hindi ko nalang siya hinayaan maging liability. If I make it a liability, ulitin ko magkamali ulit ako. But if I want to make it an asset by learning from it and, you know, sharing what I've learned, nagiging asset siya. Kaya medyo parang moving forward na lang ako.
The mere fact na you are sharing your life with us is already an asset by itself. Mm-hmm. Kasi it gives the signal or the message to the viewers na pwede mong gawin magbago uli. Diba, Olive?
Yeah, sabi ko nga kanina, di ba, walang, hindi nag-i-exist yung parole and probation if we don't believe in change.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi yung mga criminal offenders, mumabalik din sila, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
Magkakamali man tayo, yes, but what is important is we learn from that mistake.
Mm-hmm.
And syempre, kasi we learn already from it, hindi na natin yun babalikan.
So how should parents react to their teeners, to their teenagers who are prodigals right now?
Parents, huwag tayong matakot. Kasi mm-hmm. sa totoo lang, sabi ko nga kanina, each of us have their own life. We're not really in control of everything.
Mm-hmm.
But what is important is, andun ka kung kailan siya babalik, andun ka din to guide him. Never stop loving him
mm-hmm.
and care for him.
At saka dapat nandun ka pag bumagsak siya ulit.
Pag bumagsak siya ulit, andun ka pa din.
Uh-huh.
Kasi we don't own their life. It's their life.
In tapos, other words, what you're trying to say, Olive, there's unconditional acceptance and loving.
Uh-huh.
Di ba?
Ganun
sa mga magulang dapat.
Ka, uh-huh. Tawag nito,
children also, yung mga teens natin ngayon, you should also learn to control your impulses. Yung how to manage yung emotions mo, the way you react to situations na nangyayari. Analyze mo muna if what you're doing is, does it lead to self-destruction na ba? Or do you really have other way of solving it?
Mm-hmm. Kasi minsan, nangyayari, parang they find it as a solution to a problem, to an existing problem, which is like, for example, it's a dysfunctional home. O kaya naman, wala si nanay, wala si tatay, walang oras sa'yo.
Bakit kung naman, pag ginagawa mo ba yan, naiiba ba yung situation?
Will it change the situation?
Kasi hindi tayo pwedeng mamili kung sino yung parents natin, nor the parents can choose who their children are. Mm-hmm. Andun na yun, di ba?
So what are the things that a parent who is watching now, who is having a problem child maybe, should do? Or what are the warning signals na hetong anak ko, kailangan ko ng tulong? Kasi syempre, hindi lang naman yun dapat salo mo as magulang eh. Kaya you can seek help, di ba? So what are the warning signals na heto, dapat kailangan ko tulungan at kailangan ko ng professional help also?
First thing first, siguro hindi ko natatanong sa kanila eh. Were there a point na talagang kinakausap ka heart to heart ng parent mo?
Did you have that episode or chance?
Wala talaga. Kasi wala yung parents.
Kasi wala parents niya. No. Ikaw, Sean, were you?
A lot of times.
Pero yun nga, engulfed na siya sa addiction. Dapat prior to that, I just don't know. Kaya lang, sometimes because busy din yung parents, hindi nila nakikita yung signal na kailangan na pala niya ng ganito. Kasi one thing, maganda din yung ini-invite natin yung mga barkada ng mga anak natin. Hayaan muna natin, kahit nagkakalat yan eh. Mm-hmm. At least we get to know what they're doing and who they are.
Mm-hmm. In other words, parents should be open to accepting into their homes yung barkadas. Uh-oh. Did you have that? I mean, were your barkadas welcome in your homes? O ang feeling ninyo, isa yan sa reason bakit naging astray din kayo? Kasi syempre, hindi alam talaga ng mga magulang nyo sino mga kaibigan ninyo. Ikaw, Jan?
My parents were... hesitant sila mo dawat sa friends kay since kung namin sa balay magubot-gubot lang.
What about you, Sean? Were they?
Sa akin, the other way around, they want to see my friends.
And yet you didn't want
to. I didn't want to show them.
So yes.
And your reason is that because alam mo na ayaw nila because of what you're doing.
So parang you were afraid na i-reject sila ng parents mo or pintasan.
Kasi alam na nila yung mga ginagawa nila sa labas.
So that's a good tip to our parents, ha, na they should accept the friends inside their homes para makilala din nila at alam nila kung ano
ginagawa. Pwede mo naman kasing can I go with you sometimes just to meet them? And then, hayaan ko na kayo. Like, let's say, for example, nagmumalling kayo. Sige, hatid muna kita doon. Parang hatid lang kumbaga, but already nakita mo na sila, di ba?
So it's very important, you get to know who they hang out with. So mahalaga yun. So do you think, Shana, if that was done years back in your life, medyo hindi ka aabot ng 4 rehabs? Or it would not have changed things also?
Hindi ko masabi yan, Doc, kasi marami namang factors para maano yun. But again, malaking ano rin siya, meron din siyang effect. Mas advantageous, of course, if you monitor the friends of your children as early as possible.
How do you feel na alam mo naman na it saddens your parents na heto yung ginagawa ninyo? Siyempre, we know already na heto yung ginagawa niyo pleasure and then you forget na merong guilt feelings doon. Pero nakikita ninyo na parang, siyempre, the parents will always feel na bad, na you are going astray. Like ikaw, you were into drugs, ikaw ganito din. So when you see your parents feel sad about what you are doing, does it, tug at your heart na parang, oops, teka, I'm also hurting my family? Or wala talaga at that stage in your life? Ikaw, Jenny?
The later parts na akong life.
Later part na. Pero nung una, wala?
Wala.
So kumbaga kahit na umiyak si mama at si papa doon, wala kang pakialam pa rin?
Definitely, maraga na ganito.
Ang sa emo siya.
Well, yung remorse comes in when I'm drug-free. Pero pag, as long as there's drugs inside me, there's walang remorse talaga yan.
Was there something, the way you were brought up, na sa tingin ninyo, if it was changed, or parang meron ba kayong concept na kung heto ang pagpalaki sa akin at heto yung aming family set up, ay hindi nangyari ito sa akin? Did it come to that point or wala naman? Talagang wala yun, hindi yun na factor in?
Sa akin naman, Doc, siguro pag andun lang yung intact lang yung ano namin, yung family namin. Siguro malaking factor na. Siguro nakadaan ako nung ano, early parts akong life, but then it would ano siguro early part po sa akong life nga mawala siya.
Uh-huh. What about you, Sean?
Well, para sa akin, Doc, hindi ko masabi ano kasi if sabihin natin na, let's say there was a misunderstanding between my parents, mm-hmm. bakit yung mga kapatid ko, mm-hmm. okay naman sila?
Uh-huh.
But ako lang hindi.
Oh, yeah, that's
so
true,
I cannot really say na kung ganito, baka maging maayos.
Will discipline, or have, if you were disciplined at the time in your life, do you think that would have helped you? Or you would still rebel with whatever kind of discipline that was implemented? Ikaw kaya, Jan?
Depende po siguro, Doc.
Depending kay, nga po.
Yeah. Kay, sa akong self siguro, mag, nagi siya kanang type nga mag-rebuild, mag-go against ko sa kuan, kung mm-hmm. sa ilay rules sa among family, sa balay na mo.
Mm-hmm.
And some factors po, ako mga friends, no? Ang daway ila pong family, inana, and then ilang mga lifestyle, nani po. So,
grabe ang influence, ano, sa ano peer. Well, would you say na the peer pressure there or influence of your friends also, you know, was among the factors na nag-consider mo?
Sa kanilang dalawa, yeah.
Yeah?
Yung, uh-huh. ano, yung sa labas talaga, yung mga friends.
Mm-hmm.
And going back to your question kanina, when, no? Ano yung signal na talagang you really needed for professional help? Yun palang failing grades. Kasi pag nakikita mong they're no longer functioning normally. In a sense na hindi na nila nagagawa yung dapat nilang gawin as a person daily, no? That really calls for help already.
Did you find help immediately, Sean? Or matagal pa? Was there denial in the family with what you were doing?
Of course, nung una talaga, Doc. Actually, yung first ko, it was a volunteer. I volunteered myself.
Mm.
Sinabi ko, Ma, Dad, I'm into drugs. Can you help me?
Wow.
So there was a call for help.
Ganda, no?
Ang galing eh. Oh, not everybody would do that. Sige, patuloy.
And then so we were looking at the directory, yellow pages pa noon eh. Naghahanap kami na rehab.
Rehab center.
And, you know,
you were in Manila at that time.
Manila po.
Uh-huh. And then so how do you make of it, Olive? Na siya mismo ang nag-cry for
maganda
help.
Maganda yun. Eh, tayo nga dito ngayon, we have what we call voluntary confinement. Eh.
Mm-hmm.
And we, kami yung isa sa mga agency who will be going there to help them. Ipaprocess para voluntary confinement yung ano. So mas maganda din yung supposedly, kaya nga sabi ko, first stage pa lang, andun na yun eh. Dapat na-stop na siya. Kaya if you started by realization, ikaw gud mismo ang ni ano, mas paspas magun ang help, mas paspas pun ang therapeutic process,
mm-hmm.
punta.
Mm-hmm.
Pero I'm wondering, bakit bumalik pa din?
Why did you revert back to the old ways?
Ano pa rin, Doc, eh. Like what I said kanina, yung process ng ano ko, talaga matigas yung ulo ko.
So, like, parang sa personality na niya,
uh-huh.
parang doon yung problema, more or less, sabi niya kanina, andun yung mga self-pity, andun yung merong dapat i-process sa kanya,
mm-hmm.
not just the drugs,
mm-hmm.
but I think yung
behavior niya mismo, kumbaga it has to be an extensive
i-address dapat.
Uh-huh. So now that you're a parent, you're already a father also with a child, eh, would you say na you wouldn't want your child to go through what you went through?
Yeah, yes, Doc, actually palagi nagfa-flashback sa akin sinasabi ni Papa yan, na you'll be a parent also. Remember this, you'll be a parent. Ginagano niya ako eh. And it's happening.
Mm-hmm.
Naging parent ko nga, no, mahirap din pala.
Mm-hmm.
So,
but your experiences will help you. Do you think na, do you believe na the experiences that you had will help you to become a better father to your child?
Yeah, para sa akin, Doc, of course. It's not something that you can be proud of na,
mm-hmm.
kumbaga, sabi na nagbago na si daddy, pero addict pa rin yan eh. Di ba? Hindi pa rin yung pwede ipagmalaki. But again, yung naging experience ko ng mga mali, I hope lang na hindi na nila sundin.
Mm-hmm.
And they would make a better decision this time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Gusto ko yung sagot niya. Kasi yung ibang parents, sabi nila, oy, alam ko na yung ginagawa mo, andyan ako.
I've been there.
So, wag mo na yung gawin kasi ganito, ganyan. Ang tendency niya, naiinis yung bata nun eh.
Mm-hmm.
Talaga. Yung uh-huh. parang, sige nga.
Uh-huh. So, mas maganda yung attitude ni Sean.
Maganda yung attitude niya.
Which he should maintain eh. throughout, no? What about you, Johnny? If you become a parent also, do you think na you will be a better father to your child or children knowing na you've been through that, eh? Lalo na ngayon kasi ang dami-dami talagang temptation sa mga kabataan natin ngayon. So, do you think you'd be a better person, better able to handle the growing up children of this millennial?
I think so, if with God's help. And siguro, mas more yung understanding ko sa and kung saan pag-manage ang kuan my children to be in the future. In reflecting back, no, my old ways, no, siguro, mas advantageous sa, no, sa kuan part. Kay, sa atong kuan, kung maobserbahan nato ang behavior sa bata, so maka-realize na ta kung unsa ay kuan kanang unsa atong kind of management or discipline nga ilang i-implement sila.
And what about, you know, your future? How do you see your future from today? Ikaw siya.
Well, since I'm drug free already, mas brighter siya, mas maganda. But again, I'm very cautious about having the humility na maging consistent kasi may tendency pag sinabi kong okay na ako, drug free na, kaya ko na, ang yabang na naman nalalabas and magiging lax ako na naman. So I just have to be consistent para mas maganda yung future.
Yes, what about you, Jenny? What do you think? What do you see your future to be?
Yeah, same with Shan nga dapat i-maintain yung kuan consistency sa kung unsay nakaroon nga I am free with those things already.
Would you say na the support and acceptance of your family and friends is a huge factor on you being able to achieve your goal, which is to be a better person than you were in the past?
Well, ako, Doc, sa totoo lang, since I came from, I'm from a political family, no? Came from a political family. It's very crucial to disclose this kind of, ano?
Yes.
Kasi, ano to eh, napaka sacred eh. Now, having to tell, to confess everything to the public is already a good sign na hindi ko na talaga babalikan kasi nasabi mo na eh. So it's like
commitment already, practice what you teach
you know.
So Olive, not everybody will be as successful as these two young men na from bad to worse to good sila
Yeah, but so, I still believe that everybody who are still in the dark right now will still have the chance to go out. Andun pa rin yun. With the proper guidance, with the acceptance of those people who really love them, lalabas pa din sila.
And they will be able to shine again and find their ways.
Exactly.
So napakabilis po ng oras ko dito sa Dynamic Living The Total You. Tapos na po ang aking isang oras at napakaganda na ating usapan because it is actually going back to the very basics of being a human person. I'd like to thank my guests and my guest. Maybe you have something to share to the viewers, your words of inspiration, Johnny?
Yeah, I'd like to cite one verse coming from the Bible, Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. Whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, lovely, pure, and of good report, think on these things.
Yes, and what about Shan?
Yes, thank you for having me here. Anyway, for the people na kapareha sa mga sitwasyon namin, no, especially sa addiction, there's a saying na it's smart to learn from your mistake, but it's wiser to learn from other people's mistake. So sana yung mga lalo yung mga bata, no, I encourage you to focus more on the studies. And totoo yung sinasabi ng parents nyo, if they tell you na mag-aral talaga, mag-aral kayo na mabuti. And keep away from drugs.
Okay. What about you, Olive?
First and foremost, I would like to thank our guests for, you know, being brave enough to come in and open. And talagang with that, nakikita ko na they really have the strength to really go on kung ano yung meron sila ngayon. And for the parents out there, let us all remember na we don't own our children. And just be there to love them unconditionally and be there every time they fall. And for the children, ang laki ng world, there's still a lot for you to discover, to learn. And learning is always fun, so focus muna tayo doon. But then again, whatever may happen, know that there is God. And there are people who will be helping you out.
Mm-hmm. And tandaan po natin mga magulang, ang ating mga kawataan, these are borrowed from the Lord. They are gifts that we are supposed to treasure, to nurture, to love, and to guide. At mga kawataan naman, tandaan po natin, pag sinira at winasak natin ang ating buhay at ating kinabukasan, sa atin pa rin babalik at babalik yan. And remember that whatever our guests have said and shared tonight, this will also help us in our, you know, in our journey through this earth. Magandang gabi po sa ating lahat.
Before you 7,107 islands to enjoy with 7,107 possibilities and more. We have just landed on the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Maligayang pagdating sa Pilipinas.
Once considered as the tiger economy of Asia, the Philippines continues its slow yet steady climb to becoming an international business hub. Having been Christianized by her colonizers in the early 1500s, the Philippines now stands alone as the last bulwark of Christianity in this part of the world. Yet, she is not exempt from moral and social issues that beset nations big and small in this postmodern era. Yes, she needs Jesus now more than ever. Her 144 cities, with an average of 500,000 residents each, certainly need hope. An answered prayer, Hope Channel now covers the entire nation. Hope Channel Media Centers now stand in Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao to bear testimony of Jesus' love. And in just a few years, many have rediscovered the beauty of life with hope.
Na-revive ko, pinagi sa pagtanaw na ko sa Hope Channel Philippines.
Malaki po ang magagawa ng Hope Channel para po sa pagtatapos ng gawain.
The good news that Hope Channel has brought to the archipelago has inspired a Filipino to see beauty and brought joy back in spite of it all. Sapphire seas and pristine coastlines, lush vegetation, gorgeous landscapes. With warm, fun-loving, and industrious people, the Philippines is paradise. Here is a fertile land for business, education, manpower, many other resources, and sharing the good news. Because the Pearl of the Orient Seas now has the Pearl of Great Price. The Philippines plus Hope Channel equals unlimited possibilities of sharing love, changing lives. Panimbaya na! Matag Sabado, alas 6 sa buntag.
Panimbaya! CDEO University!
Dapat, especially to my family.
Ma-enjoy ka sa matahong ng mga awit. Community service o langit ng panalangin. Gikan sa Panimbaya sa Kabuntagon. Sabado, alas 6 sa buntag. Kita kids!